that's what we're looking at. That's the project that I'm starting, and you're welcome to go with me on this. Now, the purpose of this video is just to document the rebuild of that hot rod. That's a 1949 Dodge Coronet D30 convertible. The only reason I'm working on it is because I've got the D30 at a really smoking good deal. It's mostly there. Most of the chrome and glass, everything's there. It's not going to be a real hard part search for it. Now, it's more than body work. A lot of people look at hot rods, they think some paint, some Bondo, things like that. You're right, but that's just one piece. On that car, we're going to put disc brakes on the front, rebuild the drums on the back, redo the piping on the brakes all the way through with brake lines, things of that nature. We're going to switch it to a 12-volt system. I'm going to put an alternator on it, a 12-volt HEI distributor, 12-volt lights, 12-volt wiring harness. We're going to keep the inline 230 CI flathead Dodge engine, which currently now I believe has a stuck valve. But hey, I've been after this car for 18 years. For 18 years it sat in a field, and I asked the guy and asked the guy and asked the guy about it. Finally he said, yeah, Ray, I'll go ahead and let you have that car. So I got it. So I'm going to talk about a few things that I know about cars and products used to fix a car that might help you out down the road. Today, I'm going to just talk about a few things that I found I like best. Doesn't have anything to do with me trying out a Harbor Freight gun or anything like that. I'm just giving you the information that I use in my life to do this stuff that I've found to be good. Now, the first thing I'm going to tell you about is you can get any kind of Bondo in the world that you want. Now, I prefer this 3M Platinum. It's a Pearson product, I think they call it, Platinum Plus filler. It's a really good filler. And now, if you use this filler, you want to read these directions. Of course, this is clean all surfaces with soap and water, followed by grease and wax remover. What I do is I take it down to metal. This sticks really good to metal, 80 grit, 30 grit, whatever you want to do, get it down to metal. And you can use those. I'll show you later a video that I'm going to use when I'm stripping the car, how I go about doing it the quickest way that I've found. But this works really good. You can pick this up with a can of blue hardener. Not bad. Not bad at all. I don't know what this, what did I get for this? $70 for this gallon, which is high. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to lie to you. Another thing I want to show you here is this paint gun that I got from Walmart for $20. This paint gun is probably, I'll be lucky if it holds air, if it's tight. Look at this cap. Look at that cap. So I'm going to have to tape that closed when I use it. This is a 2.5 nozzle. See if you can see that. 2.5 right there on the top. Anyway, this is for polyester primer only. That's the only thing I'll use this gun for. I'll use the Vilvis to paint a car, but this is a polyester gun. It was $25 from Walmart. I don't know how it's going to shoot or not. It come with a real cheap air gauge. It didn't even have a male adapter on it like I have here. It had some kind of nozzle that you would tighten a hose to. It was ridiculous. So I stripped that out and put this in it. That's why I say I don't know if this is going to hold air or not. This gauge is going to work. We will see, but it's only for polyester primer, not for anything else. I wouldn't use this for, oh, this is a terrible thing. But since that polyester primer goes on like a water hose and you got to put it down fast anyway, maybe it'll work. I've never used polyester primer before. It's going to be my first time on this car, and I'm going to do it between the Bondo. I'll get the Bondo, 3M Platinum Plus, not Bondo, no. So that is the unknown, that gun. And we're just talking about body here. We're not talking about the motor, the brakes. I've got to put a drive shaft in that thing. I've got to do the interior. It's a complete piece of work. That car's not rusty. It's got surface rust on it. Floors are solid. I've already poured 15 the undercarriage. It looks good. It's going to need some shocks. It's just work. It's what it takes. Work. It takes a little bit of money. So, I'm saving up money for it. As I get enough to buy something, I'll buy it. I can't find a bumper, front bumper. I might have to put a Plymouth bumper on it, I think. This is what I brought you here for. Is this right here. Now, I see guys on YouTube painting car with tractor paint, Rust-Oleum, $50 Rust-Oleum. You can do that if you want to. I'm not saying that you can't do it. You can do whatever you want. It's your car. That's my motto. It's my car. I can do whatever I want. That's the joy of ownership. But for you guys that's never painted a car and you're looking to paint a car, you need to look at an air compressor, cubic feet per minute. If you only have access to 110, I see everybody talking about these Harbor Freight Fortress, 27 gallon, 200 PSI. It's putting out about 5.255 cubic feet per minute. Now, if you took that and ran it into a 20 gallon, 30 gallon spare tank, and then run your filters off that spare tank, you might get the CFMs that you need to push a gun without a bunch of orange peel and stuff. I don't know. I've got access to an 80 gallon. It's not mine, but the thing with an 80 gallon is it's hard to get the wiring for if you don't have your own shop or if you're working out a small garage. You just don't have it. So, but anyway, let's talk about a guy that I've seen for years at car shows. His name is Ron. I'm going to hold up your brochure. Hot Rod Auto Paint. Okay? Can you see that? His phone number is 620-252-8925. He also has a eBay account. Hot Rod, I think it's Hot Rod Auto Paints, one word. His email address is hotrodautopaint@hotmail.com. This guy's been around forever. Now, the reason I'm telling you that is people are going to Farm Supply and getting farm implement paint, painting their vehicles with it because it's cheap. This guy has a plethora of acrylic enamel paints. And like I say, his phone number is 620-252-8925. He's got a really good reputation. Let me show you what I bought from him. The kit. I bought the complete kit. Now, this kit comes with a gallon of paint, acrylic enamel paint. Now, people say, oh, I want to do three stage. You can do three stage. You can do two stage. You can do whatever you want. I don't care. It's not my car. The car that I'm doing didn't come with that high gloss show car finish. Yeah, I can do it. But I'm telling you, I can put a red acrylic, premier red acrylic paint on there, and it's going to look fine. Now, check this out. It comes with a gallon of paint. Let me turn the label around to you. Hot Rod Auto Paint. A gallon. Now, on top of this, with that, it comes two paint sticks, mixing sticks. Okay. In this bag, mixing cup. Looks like he gave me three strainers. 180 mesh looks like. Really good. Decent, just what you would get if you went down to the paint store. Buy some more. I use two at a time strain. I strain mine into the cup and into the gun. A lot of people will pour it into the cup, mix it, strain it through two filters into the gun. Some people strain it in the cup, then pour it in the gun. I strain mine with one filter into the cup and one filter into the gun. That's me. You do what you want to do. It's your car. It comes with 1 pint of Autobahn Wet Look Acrylic Hardener. Autobahn Wet Look Acrylic. This will mix this gallon. It is an eight parts paint, 1 part hardener, and 2 parts reducer. And it comes with a half a gallon. Is that a half a gallon? I don't know. Maybe a quart of reducer. So this reducer will go into that gallon of paint. So what I'll do is when I mix, I've got the mixing cup, right? So when I mix the first paint gun, I'll mix it 8 to 1, right there, 8 to 1 to 1. We know it's 8 to 1 to 2. So I'll put the 7, I'll go to the 7 line. I'll go up to the 7 line on the paint, the 7 line on the hardener, and then I'll come up to the rim ring with reducer. I'll mix that and put it in a spray can, spray cup of the paint gun. Then, once I get that out of the gallon, I'll take this, what's left, and I'll pour it into the whole gallon. And then I'll mix that gallon up with a paint lid with a spinner on it, a little propeller on the bottom that keeps it turned up. I'll mix that in there. Then I'll pour that directly into my paint cup and only add the hardener, and then use the stir stick to stick, mix that up. Now, it's a lot of car to paint, but if you noticed, it's convertible. So I don't have a roof to do. I only have to do the interior panels and the exterior of the car. So that's the paint kit that you can get from Ron, and I'll show you that again. It's very important to keep this all sealed up in its bags and keep it warm till you use it. I might not paint this car till the summer, but I got my paint, and I'm going to tell you why. This kit that I just showed you, expertly mixed paint from Ron at a Hot Rod Auto Paints. I've seen this guy at car shows for years. He's got his booth, and he goes out and he sells that paint at car shows. You can order it from him. Now, let me just read you some of his prices. Acrylic enamel auto paint gallon. If you just want the paint, it's $50. You want the acrylic enamel auto paint kit set up that I have sitting beside me here that I bought. 1 gallon kit, paint a small car, or in my case, a convertible, $70. Reducer, a quarter reducer, $7. Enamel reducers, $15. That Wet Look Hardener that is in my kit is $20. Now, clear coat with activator, I'm not going to use that. I'm going to just use this enamel single stage. $80. 2K urethane primer with activator kit set up. That's a gallon kit, $75. That's about average. Now, what I did find when I bought his acrylic enamel auto paint for $70, after shipping, I actually have, I don't think I ordered anything extra from him. I think it came in right at $105.42. But shipping on that, that's heavy. Shipping is shipping. And it's a box within a box. And it was really well packed. One thing I thought that was really cool, the high build primer, acrylic lacquer high build primer is $50. He sells Durablocks. I call for prices. He's got sticky back paper, $20. The rounds, 6 inches, 80 grits, $35 for a box. Sticky back 180, 220, 320, 400 grit, $30, which I'm going to order probably a pack of those. I'm going to check around and see if I can find them local cheaper. This I thought was a really good deal. Z-Grip plastic body filler with one tube of blue hardener, $30. That's a lot cheaper than the 3M that I'm using, but I'm going with what I know that works. I had rather not experiment, because you know how long experiments can take. Evercoat lightweight body filler with one tube of blue hardener. That would be like, I'm thinking that's kind of probably Evercoat lightweight. It's probably along around like Dyna glass or something like that. It's really close to what I've got here, but you might have a little more pin holes, but it will work. And that's really cheap, $20 for a gallon. 3/4 3mL tape, 2 rolls, $7. He sells paint guns. I don't know about those. Paint guns are something that you have to find the one that's right for you. I'm going to use the Vilvis on this car. Acrylic lacquer thinner for a gallon is $15. You know, that's about what it would be anywhere for if you want to clean up your guns and stuff. He's got his 3M respirators. He does sell the 5-gallon lacquer thinner for $40. 3M respirators for $25. 10 mixing cups for $5. Scotch-Brite pads, $25 a box. And number 500 workload fender stands, or 500-pound workload fender stands, $45 a piece. You can get those at Harbor Freight. Really cheap, like $18 to $25. So if you're going to get your fender stands, or you're going to get you need a few of those. I'm telling you, get them. It doesn't matter. It's Harbor Freight, but it's a stand. It's not like you're buying a car engine. So that's that. And this guy, I'm telling you, if you want a quality paint for a value you can afford, this is your guy. This is him. That's all for today, and thanks for watching, and stay tuned. Come back and see what we're doing. I'm going to keep rolling this through. I don't know how long it's going to take. I've got an idea in my head, an estimation. The goal is to have it done by the end of summer so that I can at least go to one or two car shows before the end of the year with that car. It's going to be fun. I've got a guy that I'm going to talk to about my interior. And I'll hand that, any of these deals that I have going on that I think you might be interested in knowing, I'll let you know where I'm getting it, how I'm doing it. Paint this guy. And this is just one part of the big picture. So, I'm Ray, just another car guy. Colorado Springs, Colorado. And I'm a therapist by trade. But Corona's got us locked down right now, so stay tuned. Thank you for sharing this time with me. I hope that this helped you out. Ron is his name, 620-252-8925. He's got an eBay store, but all these colors he has will not be on the eBay store, okay? And where are you? This one right here where my finger is, it's called Premier Red. You see it there? Right there? Premier Red. That one. And it's going to look really good. I'm going to pour it over white primer to give it a brilliance that I want. I want a brilliant red. I don't want a candy apple dark red, which is all the phase right now. But on that old car, you want bright, bright red, gangster white wall tires, you know, some really good dog bowl hubcaps, just to make it good old Miss Miami. That's what I'm going to call that car, Miss Miami. So stay tuned, man. It's good to see you. Keep your head down, okay? We'll see you around.